All right, that's fine. It's fine.
It's fine. Everything's okay, future Willis. Solid-state drives have clear advantages over old-school hard disk drives. They're faster, quieter, and consume less power. But while choosing an SSD can seem complex, well, with all the acronyms you'll see when looking at specs, it's really quite simple. You just need to choose the right form factor and the right speed for your situation.
This video is sponsored by SK Hynix, the maker of fastest-in-class SSDs. SK Hynix developed the world's first 128-layer NAND-based consumer SSD and is the world's second-largest memory manufacturer. But what really sets them apart is incredible performance at affordable prices, surprising power efficiency, and 5-year warranties. In fact, SK Hynix makes PC World's top picks for best all-around SSD and best NVMe SSD. Grab the gold P31 or S31 on Amazon and give your PC a big upgrade.
Let's tackle form factors first. SSDs can come in multiple shapes and sizes, but the two most common forms are 2.5-inch drives and M.2 drives. Each have their advantages. M.2 drives don't require additional cables because they connect directly to your motherboard, and some types are faster than 2.5-inch drives. For their part, 2.5-inch drives are often cheaper. Other less common form factors include PCIe add-in cards and U.2 drives, both of which are used in desktop PCs. PCIe add-in cards connect to your motherboard using the same type of PCIe slots that a graphics card or a sound card does, while U.2 drives only work if a U.2 connector has been included on the motherboard or you have an adapter to use it in an M.2 slot. As you might guess, U.2 drives are the most rare form factor. So how do you pick between the two main types? Again, that's the M.2 and 2.5-inch form factors. Well, that depends on what your desktop or laptop can support. For systems with modern hardware or slightly older high-end hardware, you'll usually have your choice of both M.2 and 2.5-inch drives, so your building preferences and budget, along with parts availability, will have more influence on your selection. Many people don't even choose between the two and instead go with a combination, usually M.2 for your boot drive and one or more 2.5-inch drives for tasks that would feel slow using a more spacious hard disk drive. That would be like for gaming or video rendering. For older desktop systems, you'll likely be stuck with just 2.5-inch drives as your option. If you really want the faster speeds you can get with some M.2 drives, you can look at PCIe add-in adapter cards, but you'll need to first make sure that the PCIe slots on your motherboard are compatible. As for laptops, if you can choose between SSD form factors when configuring a new notebook, choose whichever option offers the best value and performance relative to the cost. But with most new laptops, you won't get to decide. For upgrades on older laptops, you may also not get a choice. The laptop's configuration may limit you to only one form factor. To figure out if your model has an M.2 slot, a 2.5-inch drive bay, or both, you'll need to find its service manual online or do research on forums and Reddit. You can also try contacting the manufacturer's customer support. Be sure to buy a drive compatible with your laptop. Pay attention to details like interface type, which I'll cover in the next section, and the Z height of your original 2.5-inch drive as applicable. Also check reviews to find out the power consumption of any specific SSD you're considering, as it will have an impact on your battery life. Now let's move on to speed. When an SSD is referred to as being a SATA or an NVMe drive, you're hearing essentially shorthand for the speed range you can expect from it. You see, not all SSDs use the same digital interface to transfer data. Some still use serial ATA or SATA, while newer models use the Non-Volatile Memory Express protocol, or NVMe protocol, over PCIe Express. SATA is older, and as you'd expect, SATA drives are slower than the NVMe variety. But there's still a huge improvement over a hard disk drive. Their average read and write speeds fall in the range of 500 megabytes per second, which is between 3 and 6 times faster than a hard disk drive. For example, the S31 we have here is rated at 560 megabytes per second for read speed, 525 megabytes per second for write speed, and hit 562 and 511 megabytes per second respectively in our benchmark tests. Combine that with affordable prices and you have a great option for cost-conscious PC builds and upgrades. I now regularly recommend SATA SSDs to everyone buying a new PC, and especially so when doing an upgrade on an old PC. The performance boost over hard disk drives is so substantial, even in mundane situations like loading a website, that for most people, it feels like a completely different computer. That said, NVMe drives are blazing fast compared to SATA drives, and it shows. Right now, most NVMe drives are between 5 to 6 times faster than SATA drives, and a newer variety currently tops out at about 10 times as fast. As manufacturers refine their designs and release more models of that quicker variety, the speed of NVMe drives will continue to climb the charts. The terms you need to know when digging through specs for NVMe drives are PCIe Gen 3, sometimes written as PCIe 3.0, and PCIe Gen 4, sometimes written as PCIe 4.0. You'll also want to note if they're being listed as by 2 or by 4, which will be written as X2 and X4, and is a reference to the number of PCIe lanes the drives can use. The more lanes, the more data the drive can transfer at one time. Current PCIe Gen 3 by 4 drives average speed between 2500 and 3200 megabytes per second for reads and writes, while current PCIe Gen 4 by 4 drives average 5000 megabytes per second. The P31 that we have here as our example is a PCIe Gen 3 drive that's rated at 3500 megabytes per second for read speed, 3200 megabytes per second for write speed, and hits 3,521 megabytes per second and 3,457 megabytes per second, respectively, in our benchmark tests. If all that related to NVMe drives was simply too much acronym soup, just remember that the bigger the numbers, the faster the drive should be. All right, so how do you choose? Well, similar to form factor, you don't always get to make that decision. 2.5-inch drives are all SATA drives. And while M.2 drives come in both the SATA and NVMe varieties, what your motherboard supports dictates what you should buy. M.2 slots can support only SATA, only NVMe, or both. In desktop PCs, you'll see at least one slot on the board that supports both, and sometimes a second one that either supports both or just SATA. In laptops, it can be any one of those three scenarios, so you'll need to find out your specific model's specs. If you do get a say in the interface type, consider SATA drives as sufficiently quick for everyday tasks and even gaming, and then NVMe as great for high-performing PCs where it's important to save time on large file transfers. Overall, the age of your PC and the size of your budget will help shape your decision. And as a reminder, even if you're restricted to only SATA or only NVMe drives, individual SSDs vary in performance, which can affect your interactions with your PC. So be sure to compare specs and read reviews. Okay, last thing. You may have read or heard about the types of NAND in SSDs and might be wondering if you need to worry about those different flavors of flash memory. For most people, the answer is no. Most folks who buy an SSD don't need to dig into the pros and cons of SLC, MLC, TLC, and QLC drives. What matters more is how the drive performs when doing different types of file transfers, and you'll see those results in individual reviews. The same advice applies to DRAM-less SSDs or SSDs that lack a dynamic RAM cache. While these budget SSDs can be slower in some aspects, they still outperform drives of pokier interface types. So, a DRAM-less NVMe drive is still faster than a SATA SSD, and a DRAM-less SATA drive is still faster than an HDD. If you're worried about the performance disparities, definitely look at the individual reviews, but don't feel like you have to stretch your budget to avoid a DRAM-less model. Only skip these when a specific model's performance is obviously bad, the drive is priced similarly to one with a DRAM cache, or if you need more even performance across the board. Alright, so hopefully that helped clarify the alphabet soup you'll encounter when choosing an SSD. If you're looking for further information on individual drives, we review SSDs on our website at pcworld.com, which you can find the link for down below. We also have further SSD coverage and other tech explanations right here in our suggested videos. And if you'd like to catch new ones as we put them out, be sure to subscribe. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time.